That's how we grow up. We're not allergic to shit, you know. We can eat peanuts. Are you kidding me? Latino allergic to peanuts? Chingada, cacabate de la chica. Salted. We do more shit with peanuts than a monkey could. I mean, we got different ways to eat peanuts. And we're not allergic to peanuts. Chile peanuts, roasted peanuts, chile. Different flavor, la tarini, la chingada, just eating peanuts. We're not allergic. Now, if somebody has a peanut allergy, the whole world has to change for that one person. When they fly on a plane, no one in the airport can have peanuts because of that one person. You're on the airplane, peanut-free flight because of that one person. You're drinking, having a good time. Hey, can we have some peanuts? I'm sorry, there's a passenger in coach in the middle seat that has a peanut allergy in 23A. Fuck him. Give me the microphone.
Orale, hey, 23A. Go hide in the bathroom because we're going to be eating some peanuts right now.
All right?
And next time, go Greyhound with all the other fucking nuts.
Why do we have to change? Because somebody has a fucking allergy. They have peanut-free schools. No peanuts in the school. You could take a gun, but don't bring no peanuts. You don't even need a gun. Just walk in with some walnuts. I'll crack these motherfuckers right here. Get on the ground. Get on the ground. I'll crack it. And don't try to run, because I threw cashews all over the parking lot. Huh? You want me to throw some fucking, you want me to put some almonds in your shirt? You want me to put some almonds down your shirt?
Here's what you need to understand about Latinos, if I haven't already explained it. We love this country. We will never hurt this country. We love this country. That new immigration law, the RISE Act, you have to already speak English to come over here. You have to already have a job and provide to the economy before you can come here. Fuck, I was looking at that shit. I'm like, fuck, I'm only one of three. Goddamn. They're trying to keep us out of this country, but they can't. This country was made by immigrants and continue to be made by immigrants, and all of it makes it great. That's what makes America great. Not some fucking fat, wobbly hair, fucking puto, not that. Donald Trump, let me tell you something. What the whore? And let me tell you, huh? He wants to crack down on immigration. He don't like immigrants. Well, then stop marrying them. Stop marrying them. What the? Huh? She doesn't speak English. Does it bother anybody that the First Lady of the United States doesn't speak English? And it hurts to watch her try. And then my husband, daddy, he'll get it, he'll die. Pobrecita, she can't talk. She's trying, está bonita, but she cannot talk. How come somebody don't talk for her? Pata fea, Even Arnold Schwarzenegger's at home, get it out. Spit it out, do it. You know how hard it is to learn English? Arnold Schwarzenegger's been in this country 50 years, and he don't fucking speak English. He tries to talk slow like you all know, and then we got the... You see that commercial for that app, Mobile Strike? Download it now on the App Store. What did he say? Up Store? Because I saw the Up Store. Download it in the Up Store.
Now, we got a lot of things, a lot of racism going on in the world right now. Who's more racist, black people or white people? Black people. You know why? Because we hate black people, too. Everything white people don't like about black people really don't like about black people. There's some shit going on with black people right now. It's like a civil war going on with black people. And there's two sides. It's black people and there's niggas. And niggas have got to go. Every time black people want to have a good time, ignorant ass niggas fuck it up. can't do shit. Can't do shit without some ignorant ass niggas fucking it up. Can't do nothing. Can't keep a disco open more than 3 weeks. Grand opening, grand closing. Can't go to a movie the first week it come out. Why? Because niggas are shooting at the screen. What kind of ignorant shit is that? Hey, that's a good movie. That's so good, I got to bust a cap in here. Hey, I love black people, but I hate niggas, bro. Oh, I hate niggas. Boy, I wish they let me join the Ku Klux Klan. Shit, I do a drive-by from here to Brooklyn. Tired of niggas, man. You can't have shit when you're around niggas. You can't have shit. You can't have no big screen TV. You can have it, but you better move it in at 3 in the morning. Painted white, hope niggas think it's a bassinet. Can't have shit in your house. Why? Because niggas will break in your house. Niggas will live next door to you, break in your house, and come over the next day and go, I heard you got robbed. Like, nigga, you thought you robbed me. You ain't hear shit because you was doing shit. Damn. Tired of niggas. Tired of niggas, man. Damn, man. You know what the worst thing about niggas? Niggas always want some credit for some shit they supposed to do. For some shit they just supposed to do. A nigga will brag about some shit a normal man just does. A nigga will say some shit like, I take care of my kids. You're supposed to, you dumb motherfucker. What are you talking about? What are you bragging about? What kind of ignorant shit is that? I ain't never been to jail. What, you want a cookie? You're not supposed to go to jail, you low expectation having motherfucker. Fuck, man, I'm tired of this shit. You know what the worst thing about niggas? The worst thing about niggas? Niggas love to not know. Nothing make a nigga happier than not knowing the answer to your question. Just ask a nigga a question. Any nigga. Hey, nigga, what's the capital of Zaire? I don't know that shit. Keeping it real. Niggas love to keep it real. Real dumb. Niggas hate knowledge. Shit. So I tell you, niggas are breaking your house. You want to save your money? Put it in your books. Because niggas don't read. Just put the money in the books. Shit, books are like kryptonite to a nigga. Here's a book. No! No! Not a book! No! No! Tired of this shit, man. Your kids can't fucking play nowhere. Every year the space gets smaller. Okay, you go from that corner to that corner. Oh, you go from that gate to that gate. By the time motherfuckers 10, he's just hopping in a circle, like. Tired of this shit, man. Tired. Fee-fi-fo-figure, boy, I hate a nigga. Boy, tired of this shit, man. Tired, man. Niggas is ignorant, love being they singing about ignorance. I heard some song the other day. It's the first of the month. Niggas are singing welfare carols. On the first day of welfare, my true love gave to me. I wish you a merry welfare and a happy food stamp. The fuck is going on? What the fuck is going on? Now they got some shit they're trying to get rid of welfare. So every time you see welfare in the news, they always show black people. Black people don't give a fuck about welfare. Niggas are shaking in their boots. Oh, they gonna take our shit. Shit, a black man that got two jobs, going to work every day, hates a nigga on welfare. Like, nigga, get a job. I got two, you can't get one? I would give you lazy ass for the mine, but you get fucked up and get laid off, they wouldn't have another nigga for 10 years. Shit, a black woman that got two kids, going to work every day, busting her ass, hates a bitch with 9 kids getting a welfare check. Like, bitch, stop fucking. Stop fucking. Stop it. Put the dick down. Put it down. Get a job. Yes, you get a job and get a job holding dicks. Whatever you do, get paid to do it. Tired of this shit, man. Tired. It ain't all black people on welfare. Shit. White people on welfare, too. White people on welfare. But we can't give a fuck about them. We just got to do our own thing. We can't go, oh, they fucked up. We could be fucked up. That's ignorant. White people on the L. Because first of all, they try to make it look like, you know, there ain't even that many black people in the country, okay? Black people are 10% of the fucking population. Black people in New York, D.C., L.A., Chicago, Atlanta, like 10 places, okay? Okay? 10 places. Ain't no black people in Minnesota. So all you find, only black people in Minnesota is Prince and Kirby Puckett, okay? Shit, the whole rest of the country, the other 40 states, is filled up with broke-ass white people. Broke-ass, living in a trailer home, eating mayonnaise sandwiches, fucking their sister, listening to John Cougar Mellencamp records. Shit, fuck out of here, man. And they need your help. Man, and I see some black people looking at me, man, why you gotta say that? Why you gotta say that? It ain't us, it's the media. It ain't us, it's the media. The media has distorted our image to make us look bad. Why must you come down on us like that, brother? It ain't us, it's the media. Please cut the fucking shit, okay? 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 When I go to the money machine tonight, all right? I ain't looking over my back for the media. I'm looking for niggas. Ted Koppel ain't never took shit from me. Niggas have. Shit, you think I got 3 guns in my house because the media outside? Oh shit, Mike Wallace, run! Fuck out of here, man. Tired of this shit. Tired.
I think pro athletes should be forced to use steroids. I think we as fans deserve the greatest athletes science can create. Let's go. Anything that will make you run faster, jump higher. I have high-definition TV. I want my athletes like my video games. Let's go. I could care less if you die at 40. You hate life after sports anyway. I'm doing you a favor. We got athletes like Randy Moss and T.O., Terrell Owens. People get upset. You sit on your couch and you say horrible things. Oh, hey, buddy, why don't you just do your job? Just do your job. Quit celebrating so much. His job is to catch a ball. It's really not that serious. But I don't care if he gets in the end zone and has a 10-minute tea party. Just don't get mad at me, though, when you're paralyzed from the neck down, being carted off the field because some free safety took your head off, and you see me in the stands going, yes, dance now, you overpaid clown. Huh? How does it feel to know God hates you? Don't worry, maybe V8 will sponsor a vegetable. Yeah, I love defense. You want points on the board, move to Indianapolis. See what that gets you. 3 points in a championship game and 7 months to explain your quarterback. The NBA, oh. If I hear one more person say how the NBA got a black eye because Ron Artest got in a fight. The Detroit Pistons versus the Pacers, the big brawl. If you could promise me every game would end like that, I would be a season ticket holder in a heartbeat. Are you serious? I'm gonna have to fight at the end of the game? Let's go. Sounds awesome. A cup of water hit Ron Artest and he went crazy. I don't like to do jokes about stereotypes, but we all know basketball players can't swim very well. All I'm saying is, that water might have hit him. He panicked. He thought he was drowning. What are you going to do? You head for higher ground. A fat white kid gets in your way, you fucking knock his ass out. He grew up with the pool. Yeah. It's a theory. It's probably wrong.